So welcome, everybody, and welcome Deb Tattersall, who has a truly unique message for us. She's recently had a brain issue, a memory issue, which she's working on to help correct. But in the meantime, she has, what's the right term? She has, with her memory problem, these are my terms now, Deb, forgotten her resentments and her angers and her griefs and her guilts, and she's ended up with a life with extraordinary peace. And she wrote, she sat down and wrote out what she wanted to say so she wouldn't have any memory problems in saying what she wants to say. That's correct, Deb?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm okay saying things, yes.
Okay. Now,
yes.
Just before we started recording, you were telling me about you used to be afraid of things like going to hospitals and so on, but now you're not. Talk about that a minute before you read this thing, and then we'll read it, okay?
Oh, that I'm completely relaxed now?
Yeah.
I am completely relaxed now, and I always feel that loving spirit every day.
But it used to
feel it for the whole world.
It used to be before you would go to the hospital for something, you would be afraid and anxious and
Oh, yeah.
And that's not the case. You had something with your foot and something with your memory. And normally you'd be like this, and you went there and there was nothing but peace.
Yes. In fact, at that one time, I even thought, oh, maybe I'm going to be going in there to die, but it's okay. And that's amazing. And yet that was just surprising. But when I was in that hospital and I was getting, you know, some things checked and stuff, I stayed awake. And then I heard other people, you know, who were getting checked about things and stuff. And then I was just asking our loving spirit to heal them.
Yeah. Okay.
To make them feel better. So.
All right. So, Deb, thank you for that. And if you would now, just take your time and read the few paragraphs you wrote.
Okay.
And that will suffice in giving the important message you have to our listeners. So go ahead.
Okay. I'll start reading now. Okay. Here's what I said. I took the lessons with Gary and Sherry quite a few years ago, and I really enjoyed that. And I really loved Gary and Sherry. I know that all of you people have started these lessons, and that you must have started these for a really good reason. Even though I got my huge memory problem, I have stayed connected with the unseen therapist, and I now call unseen therapist as loving spirit. Now that I am going to say is what I want to tell you about, and I know that unseen therapist wants me to talk to you about this. When I was young, I learned about Jesus. And then I learned that Jesus was supposed to come back to the world at some time to improve all the people in the world. What I really know now is that Jesus is our unseen therapist. I know and understand I now understand, sir, that our unseen therapist came into the world as a man, but is not a man or a woman while being unseen therapist. I also understand that when we come into the world, we all become a man or a woman. But when we die, we are not a man or a woman anymore. Quite a while ago, I started to feel the love of our unseen therapist for the world. Because I have had the memory problem, I stopped being able to listen to any of the people I am with, but I kept thinking about the loving spirit. And quite a while ago, I started to feel the love of unseen therapist for all of the people in the world. And a while ago, I started to feel that more often, and now I feel that love for the world every day. Now, every time I see people anywhere, I know that they are all loved. And unseen therapist, while I now call it loving spirit, has told me many, many times to heal the world. So, as I mentioned before, when I was younger, I had been told that Jesus would be coming back to heal the world. But now, I have been told by loving spirit that a group of people are needing to do this. And so now I am telling all of you that about this so that all of you can start to heal the world. I now feel the love for all people, and I always smile and always try to give love to little children that I see. So now, wherever my family people takes me somewhere, I feel love for everyone. And now that this can start happening with all of you, I really know, I really now feel that this group has been created to start making the people in the world to feel better. That's good. What I had to all say right. To you.
Yeah, I thank you for that very good message. Very good message.
Good.
Some people would say, Deborah, you have a disability. Mm-hmm. And that's a matter of opinion, actually. Is it a disability to love everyone under every circumstance? Is that a disability? That's an effect of what you've got. Okay. Yes. Is that?
And I can tell you that quite a number of times I have asked to have my brain healed, and I kept getting told so many times, wait until you have healed the world.
Oh, okay.
So I am meant to heal the world.
Okay, well, that little message you gave us is now going to be recorded and others will see it. And it's like the little pebble in the pond where the ripples go out. That's what we just did. Deborah, my gratitude to you, my kisses for you, my hugs, you. My hugs for you.
Thank you.
And my thank you to you.
Thank you. Thank you. Great.